Hello guys, Lucas here. How is it going? Today we're going to talk about free time in Japan. So when you think about Japan and Japanese people, you probably see a lot of people like wearing suits, carrying suitcases, going places really busy. But is it actually the truth? Well, I think of course it is, but is it actually the truth when talking about free time? Do they have the same formality? Do they have free time? Do they act formal in their free time? But before we begin, let me call my hairdresser because I have really long hair now.あの、予約したいんですけど。
はい、おいつお暇ですか？
一番早い時間はいつですか？
日曜日の11時くらいはどうですかね？
うん、大丈夫です。
大丈夫ですか？
はい。
じゃあ10日日曜日の11時からでお待ちしてます。
わかりました。
はい、ありがとうございます。
ありがとうございます。
はい、失礼します。
Okay, so I got appointment on Sunday at 11 o'clock. Fortunately, today is busy. You see, until yesterday, my hairdresser was closed and I couldn't cut my hair and it got really long. So if you're watching this, you're probably wondering what Japanese people do in their free time. In my previous video, I said Japanese kids don't have free time. Also, I mentioned that there is something called bukatsu. You see, actually it is debated if bukatsu should be considered free time.Because most people go there because everybody goes there, so they should also do it, right? However, despite the thing that bukatsu may be school activity or something, if there's like a healthy approach to it, I think it's a good thing because they have a lot of sport during that, any sport that you could imagine, like baseball, volleyball, tennis, everything. And pick any sport that you like, there's bukatsu for it. And of course,Sports are a healthy lifestyle, so everybody should do sports in their free time, right? However, if you're going to do sports 6 days a week for 6 hours, you're probably going to get injured, right? As I said, there must be a healthy approach to that. Also, bukatsu, I think it's a great tool to develop friendships that perhaps may last a lifetime. In Poland, we don't have such a custom of bukatsu, and of course we have like clubs, or like volleyball club or something like that, but it is not as heavily attended as in Japan. I'd like to mention that I am by no means Japanese person, so don't be hard on me. I don't know everything. I want to share my experience with you guys about my Japanese lifestyle and things I do here. When I make my videos, of course I share my impressions about Japan with you, but I'm also checking with my Japanese friends if the information I found is true or not. What other activities Japanese kids may have? During their free time, they will read manga,watch anime, of course. They will play outside with their friends. They will go to the arcades, which is apparently a big thing in Japan. I've never seen something like that in Poland. Of course, we have those. However, not on that scale as in Japan. There is also something called Purikura, which is a short for Purinto Kurabu, which means a print club. Basically, this is a photo booth with editing software with which you can make funny or cutephotos of yourself and your friends. This is something that Japanese girls do mostly because Japanese boys are too shy to do it. I mean, they're too embarrassed to do it because photos come out really cute and boys look like girls after that. I mean, on the photo. Until this point, I didn't mention any drinking and partying activity because in Japan, actually, you can drink from the age of 20, which I didn't know. I found that this is either like in Europe or like in United States. Okay, so let's say you want to drink with your friends. What are your options? First, there is like a home party, right? So home parties in Japan are not a thing. I mean, in Poland, we usually invite our friends for a party, for a drinking party, and everybody would buy something in the liquor store beforehand, maybe some snacks, some food. Then we gather in the apartment and we party, we dance, we drink, we laugh.Stuff like that. However, in Japan, this is not a thing. Mainly because Japanese apartments are really small. Most people live in those really small apartments, roughly about 20-30 square meters. It's hard to party in that area. By the way, if you want to dance during a party, then probably you need to go to the club because this is not a thing during like any Japanese gatherings. And yes, gatherings, because this is what I like to call them. The Japanese parties are like maybe...meetings, gatherings, and this is only my impression, so you need to take that with a pinch of salt. Okay, so drinking with a large group at the apartment is not an option. So what do you do? When Japanese people want to drink with their friends, they will probably go to the izakaya and search for nomihodai option. Nomihodai is all you can drink. This means you can drink as much as you want for 2 hours, 3 hours, or, you know, it depends on the place. They will have this really long table with tatami floor, and everybody, of course, there's no chairs. Everybody's sitting on their knees. And they will just order things from the menu, from the nomihodai menu. And they will just bring them, and you can order anything from the list. Sometimes you need to finish your drink before ordering another one. From my experience, after nomikai, everybody just goes straight to home, and that's over. That's it. We call it a day. Also, talking about drinking, there are a lot of places, such as izakayas and bars, where you can drink. And what exactly is izakaya? Izakaya is a pub where you can, is it like traditional pub where you can order alcohol and also eat something. In izakaya, they will also have a grill or something to make your own food. After work, Japanese people will usually go to izakaya to drink with their coworkers and talk about future strategies for developing their companies. Just kidding, I don't know what they're talking about, but this is my imagination. So what are the other things that Japanese people do in their free time? Here in Maebashi, I see a lot of people jogging and spending time outdoors. I see people playing tennis. Also, there's karaoke, which is a big thing, really popular in Japan. Many people go there. You can find a karaoke spot in almost all over the place. I mean, all over the town. I think I will make a video about karaoke in some time in the future. Also, I found a bunch of magazines dedicated to regional products such as food, alcohol, or onsen, which makes me think that Japanese like to travel to experience regional products of different prefectures. Okay, so taking all of that into consideration, I started thinking if Japanese have the same image of free time as we do, also if they think that having a lot of free time is actually a good thing. I know that there is a lot of stress and overworking in Japanese society, and it's true for Japanese employees and students. And for me, having enough free time to deal with that stress, to cope with it, is a necessity. So I wonder if Japanese people feel if they have enough free time to cope with it. Okay guys, that's it for today. I hope you liked the video, and if you did, hit that like button and consider sharing it with your friends. And also consider subscribing to my channel, because I will be releasing new videos really soon, so you won't miss out on anything. Thanks again for watching, and see you next time. Mata ne!